I'll now introduce you to Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling is a very good example of an ordinary differential equation working as a model for a physical system. So here's the setup. We have, say, a pot of water. This water has a fixed temperature A. You can imagine the water to be like an ice bath or to be on a burner, so its temperature is steady. And we have in the water a potato. And the temperature of the potato is going to vary, and that temperature will denote by T. Now, Newton's law of cooling is, in words, the statement that the rate of change of the temperature of the potato is proportional to the difference between the temperature of the potato and the water. Now, this is a scientific law. You figure this out by conducting experiments and making observations. Now, our job is to translate this scientific law into an ordinary differential equation, which could serve as a model for this little situation that I've introduced. So what we'll do is we'll take each piece of this sentence and turn it into a mathematical statement. So first, the rate of change of the temperature of the potato. What is that? Well, that's the derivative of capital T, the temperature, with respect to time. Second of all, the statement is proportional to. Well, that means that it's equal to, this rate of change is equal to some constant times this third part, which is the difference between the temperature of the potato and the water, and that's T minus A. Now I write equals minus K for my constant of proportionality because I want to take K to be positive. Now think for a moment about the physical correctness of the sign here. If the temperature of the potato is greater than the temperature of the water, then T minus A is positive. And I would want dT, the temperature, to be going down. So I would want this what's on the left-hand side to be negative. So that would mean that this constant should be negative. So as long as I take K greater than zero, I insert a minus sign here. Now, let's look at an example. Let's take K equals 1 and A equals 0. So that's like the physical situation having an ice bath. Now the solutions to this differential equation are pretty easy to guess, and those would be capital T of T equals C times e to the minus T. Now it's not really informative to look at just general solutions, so why don't we add an initial condition? So let's imagine that we take the potato out of boiling water and then we put it in an ice bath, freezing cold water. That would mean that I have an initial condition, T of 0 equals 100. 100 degrees Celsius would be the boiling water. And if I plug in that initial condition, I find the value C is 100. So the solution that would represent taking a potato out of boiling water and then putting it into an ice bath would be T of T equals 100 times e to the minus T. And I have a little kind of rough graph here. I start off at the value of 100 and then I decrease exponentially to zero. So that should make sense physically with what you would expect if you were to take a boiling hot potato out of water and out of a pot of water on the stove and throw it into an ice bath.